In this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can make this simple Roblox clothing design step by step. If you're completely new to Roblox clothing design, this video is for you. We're going to be going through 5 key concepts you need to understand as a Roblox designer. And by the end of this video, we're going to be making 2 versions of this outfit, a girl version and a boy version. Now for our software, I'm going to be using a free website version of Photoshop called Photopea. So you don't have to download or install anything to use this software. You just have to go to photopea.com. Now let's get started by going through the first concept you need to understand. The first principle you need to understand is using reference photos for your designs. A lot of beginner designers fall into the same first mistake, just trying to make a design without a proper goal in mind. Good designs need good references. Now, there are a lot of ways you can find good reference photos. You can go to different social media platforms like Pinterest, Twitter, or even Discord servers. Now, if you want to follow along with this tutorial, I'll be linking the reference photo that I'll be using for this video. That's step one. Let's move on to the next principle. To start, let's first grab the Roblox clothing template. To add our template, go up here on files and select open. And the file explorer should show up. Now just find the template you want to use. I'm going to be using this template I made for beginner designers. If you want to download this template, it's in my Discord server. The invite link is in the description. Let's lock this layer so that we don't accidentally move it and cause errors later. Now I'm going to be taking the reference photo I showed earlier and copy and pasting it into the template. Now I'm just going to resize this by selecting the move tool. I'm holding shift so the image stays in proportion. Now if you don't see the handlebars, don't panic. Photopea isn't broken. Just go up here on the top left bar and turn on transform controls. And while you're at it, turn on auto select so that we can select the layers on the canvas freely without manually selecting each layers on the layers panel. If you don't know how to navigate inside Photopea, you can zoom in by holding Alt or Option and using the scroll wheel, or you can press Z on your keyboard and drag left or right on your mouse, and you can pan by holding the space bar on your keyboard. Now that we have our reference photo, let's add in our base layer. To do that, let's go to the shape tool, then right click and select the rectangle. Since we'll be making the half shirt first for the girl version, make a separate rectangle for the torso and sleeve. Make sure to name these layers first by double clicking on the layer itself. Let's merge these layers by holding shift and right clicking and pressing merge shapes. Let's change the colors. Now we can use the colors from our reference photo. To do that, select the base layers and press U on your keyboard. Now in the top bar, just click on the fill icon and select the small square button. To copy the color, just hover your mouse and click the color that you want to sample from the reference photo. Now if you want to undo, just press Ctrl or Command Z. If you want to redo, just hold Ctrl or Command Shift and Z. Let's drag the template layer above the base layer so we can better see our template. Now, since the shirt has different colors and parts, we're going to have to use the pen tool to create custom shapes. To do that, just grab the pen tool, then right click and select the curvature pen tool. Now, let me show you how easy it is to make custom shapes using this tool. Let's start by making sure that the drop-down menu is set to shape instead of path. Let's start creating this curve type shape right by the armpits. Just click where the shape begins and ends to add an anchor point. Then just add another anchor point in the center to make a clean curve. Make sure that the fill color is set to a gray color. You don't want to use white. This will make more sense later. Also, make sure that the stroke is set to none. Now, we're only going to be working on one side first because we can just mirror this shape later. Let me show you that in a second. Now, if you want to straighten out certain parts of this shape, hold Ctrl or Command and click on the anchor point. This will remove the curve settings on our shape. If you want to adjust the anchor point, just go in the toolbar and select the Direct Selection tool by right-clicking. This will let you adjust the anchor points individually. And that's how easy it is to make custom shapes using the curvature pen tool. To mirror the shape to the other side, let's first duplicate this layer by pressing Ctrl or Command C to copy and V to paste. To mirror, go to Edit, Transform, and select Flip Horizontally. Now we could use the Direct Selection tool to adjust the anchor points a bit more. And I'm just going to be repeating this, but on the back side. So I'm just going to speed it up. Now Now, from our reference photo, I can kind of tell that the white parts of the shirt is connected to the backside of the shirt. So I'm going to be making a custom shape to connect these areas, still using the same tool. Then I'll just duplicate it to the other side. Alright, we're making a ton of progress. Let's make sure to save this project by going to File, Save as PSD. Now the layers panel is kind of getting crowded. Let's merge all the white shapes we made to be a little more organized. To select multiple layers, hold shift on your keyboard and right click on the layers and select merge shapes like we did before. You'll still be able to adjust the anchor points like a normal shape layer. This is called working non-destructively. So we're going to be adding a clipping mask on the white parts of the shirt. Let me show you what a clipping mask is in a second, and I'm also going to be showing you why we're going to use it. To add a clipping mask, you first need to make sure that the base layer is underneath the shape layer. Then right click on the shape layer we made and select create clipping mask. This will basically limit the pixels on the layer underneath. Now, the clipping mask is an extremely useful tool. We're gonna be using this more in just a second. Now, the next step is to add the neck hole. We can do that by grabbing the shape tool again and selecting ellipse. And just try to recreate the neck hole part. I'm holding shift to keep the proportions. I'm holding the space bar to move the shapes while I'm laying it down. Now I'm just going to align this to the center using the template as a guide. Now make sure that the fill is set to none. This is the opposite of what we did earlier. Now just select a color for the stroke. Just use the same color that we used from our base layer. Set the pixel size to 5 or whatever you think works the best. We can use the direct selection tool so we can make uneven and imperfections just like how a real shirt works.
The next step is to make the hole
by using the mask. I'm going to show you in a second why we're going to be using this tool instead of the eraser. To add a mask, go down here on the layers panel and press this small icon. Make sure that the base layer is selected. Now this will create a new tiny white thumbnail beside the layer. This will basically let you reveal and hide parts of the layers depending on the color. We can hide parts of the layers by grabbing the brush tool and making sure that the hardness is set to 100. Make sure that the foreground color is set to black. This will basically let us hide whatever we paint on. And if we switch colors from black to white, we can reveal parts of the layers. White reveals and black hides parts of the layer. Now just erase the circle from the neck hole. Alright, so this is looking trash. Now most tutorials probably end right here. They won't show you the good stuff. And we're exactly like them. Thank you for watching this video. Hope to see you in the next one. Right, so let's actually make this look less trashy. But before that, make sure you subscribe and hit the like button if you're enjoying the video so far. It would really help this channel and would really help us make more videos like this. Let's add a bit of detail and imperfections. We can do that by grabbing the curvature pen tool and adding some extra anchor points on the base layer to add some wrinkles and imperfections. And I'm going to be doing the same thing both for this leaves. Make sure you don't overdo it because it would look really weird. It's very small detail, but it will look amazing once you upload it in Roblox. Now I'm just going to extend the anchor points on the white parts of the shirt. This will make more sense later. I'm just going to select them using the direct selection tool and drag them down. Now let's add some textures. I'm going to be using this wrinkled image I found online. I'm going to link this in the description if you want to download it. Now I'm just going to align this on the base layer using the selection tool. I'm also going to change the blending mode to multiply to make it transparent. We can decrease the opacity to make it look a bit more subtle. Now just create the clipping mask on the base layer. I'm just going to repeat this process throughout the whole shirt by copy and pasting it. You can always go back and adjust the opacity if you think that it's too much. Remember that these small details should be very subtle. Now, I'm just adjusting the alignment again using the move tool. Now that that's done, let's add some shading to make it look 1,000 times better. Let's first add some general shading. Now I'm going to be using the shading template that you can find on my Discord server. I'm going to put this above the base layers and the texture layers we made, using the arrow keys again to better align it to the template. And I'm also going to make a clipping mask. Let's decrease the opacity to make it a bit more subtle. Let's go one step further by adding some wrinkles. Since I want to keep this tutorial as short as it already is, I'm just going to use the pre-made shading template. Now, this shading template is part of the monthly clothing assets you get from the asset pack. If you want to learn more about the clothing asset pack, then make sure to visit our website at robloxdesignschool.com/asset pack. But you can also make your own shading template that looks like this. I've actually made a tutorial on this before. I'm going to link it on the top right corner of your screen and in the description below. Now, since this specific shading is meant to be for long sleeve shirts and this is a half shirt, I'm just going to move it up a bit to make it look more cohesive. Let's create a clipping mask again as we did before and also adjust the opacity. Now, as you can notice, the neck hole outline is kind of standing out. We can fix this by dragging this layer underneath the texture and the shading layers we made and just add a clipping mask. Now, you probably don't need to do this part, but earlier I didn't do a good job masking the neck hole. So I'm just going to go back and adjust the mask a bit more. We can go one step further by adding some highlight. To do that, make a new layer and add a clipping mask. Now, just grab the brush tool and right-click on the canvas and select a soft round brush. Make sure that foreground color is set to white. Now you can adjust the size of the brush however you like. We're going to be painting on the center parts of the template. Now you can adjust the flow of the brush to 40% to make it a bit more subtle. Now let's just continue to brush on the center areas. Let's change the blending mode of this layer to overlay to help blend these two colors. And let's also decrease the opacity. You can always use the eraser to make some parts a bit more subtle. We can add some more small detail by adding some shadows on the base layer. To do that, make sure to select the base layer and go down here on the layers panel and select this small effects icon and select drop shadow. You can play around with the settings if you want, but I'm just going to stick with the settings I've already set up. Now, the next principle is one of the most important you need to understand, but you probably never thought of. And that is testing your designs before you upload them. To do that, let's turn off the template layer and the reference photo by pressing the eye icon so that it doesn't cause any problems once we upload it on Roblox. Let's export this as a PNG by going to File, Export as PNG. Now, a common misconception is that you need a template in order for you to upload your clothing designs on Roblox. And this is not true. You don't actually need to upload your designs with a template, as long as the size of the image is 585 pixels wide and 559 pixels tall. It should be able to work. Now, to test this, I'd recommend that you use a tool called Roviewer. It's basically a website that lets you test out your clothing designs for free. Just drag in your file and you should be able to see what it looks like. You can visit the site at roviewer.com. I'll link it in the description below. You can add some more adjustments if you want to, but I'm pretty satisfied with mine, so I'm not gonna edit it further. Now, at the beginning of this video, I mentioned that I was gonna show you how you can make a boy version of this shirt. Let me show you exactly that. To start, select the base layer and using the direct selection tool, select the anchor points underneath and drag them down using the arrow keys. Now, for the white parts of the shirt, I'm just gonna repeat the same process. And that is the power of using shape layers for your designs. Now, the shading isn't really lining up. To fix this, first make sure that the shading layer is selected, then grab the rectangular selection tool and select the torso part of the shading. Then make sure to rasterize this layer by right-clicking on the layer and selecting rasterize. Then let's copy this layer by pressing Ctrl or Command C. Then press the delete key on your keyboard. Now just paste this layer by pressing Ctrl or Command V. This created a new layer. Let's just adjust the size of the shading and decrease the opacity like we did before. Now, this part is optional, but I want to change the shading of the shirt to add some more variations. I can do that by adding the shading image I made specifically for this case. Now, the shading preset is part of our upcoming product, the Ultimate Shading Pack. I'm going to be releasing this product pretty soon, so make sure you subscribe to get updated. I'm going to change the blending mode to multiply to make it transparent, and I'm also going to decrease the opacity. I'm going to use the mask to erase some parts and make it a bit more subtle. Now let's change the color. To do that, select the base layer and press U on your keyboard and select fill as we did before. Let's use a dark gray color. You don't want to choose a really dark color because you won't be able to see the shading.
You could do the same thing for the neck hole outline layer.
And there we go, you just created your first clothing design. If you want to watch another tutorial, click on the video on the right side of your screen. And make sure you subscribe to see more videos like this.